Welcome to Vidya Mirror. This video is made for class 9 on chapter number 1 number systems, and today we are going to begin with exercise 1.3 from NCERT. Question number 1. Write the following in decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansion each has. Now what we are going to do is we will divide all the fractions and see whether it is terminating, repeating, non-terminating or repeating. According to the division we will do its analysis. Number 1. 36 upon 100. We know we can easily put decimal places for this. Answer comes 0.36 and it will stop over here. That means it is a terminating decimal. Number 2. 1 upon 11. You need to divide and see what will happen when you divide 1 by 11. You see that it comes as 0.0909 and it goes on repeating and your remainder comes as 1. So it means that we will put a bar on 09 and it means it is a non-terminating and repeated decimal. 4 by 1 by 8 can be written as 33 upon 8. So we will divide 33 by 8 and we see that we will stop, remainder comes as 0 and our quotient comes as 4.125. It means it is a terminating decimal. 3 by 13. So let's divide 3 by 13. You will see when you go on dividing, you will reach to the remainder, which comes again as 3, which is your normal dividend. So our number or quotient comes as 0.230769. Now after reaching 9, the number will again repeat to 230769 because we have reached to the remainder 3 again. So we will put a bar on 230769, which means that this particular fraction, on dividing, it is a non-terminating and repeating. The numbers will repeat after 9 the same digits and it is a non-terminating. 2 by 11, so divide 2 by 11, you will reach remainder 2 again after some steps and you will see that the numbers repeating as 0.18. We will put a bar on 18, so answer becomes non-terminating and repeating. 329 divided by 400. Now here on dividing, after some steps we will see remainder comes out to be 0. It means our answer is 0.8225 and it becomes a terminating decimal. Next, you know that 1 upon 7 is equal to 0.142857. Can you predict what the decimal expansion of 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7 and so on actually without doing the long division? If so, how? Now, this 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7 can be written as 2 multiplied by 1 upon 7. 3 upon 7 can be written as 3 into 1 by 7. So, 1 by 7 we are already given as 0.142857 repeating on the bar, it is there. So, we will multiply this and we will get the results with the bar. So, that means without even doing actual long division, we can get the answer for this. Express the following in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. Now here 0.6 bar means I can write it as 0.6666 will be repeating. So let me assume x is equal to 0.6 and let it be equation number 1. Now for the next step, I will multiply both the sides by 10. I will do it in such a manner that my numbers after the decimals remain same so that I can cut and my calculations becomes easier. So when I solve it, then you will come to know what I am trying to say. So my equation 2 is 10x is equal to 6.6666 and I will subtract equation 1 from equation number 2. So I will write second equation first and it is 10x. So 10x is equal to 6.666 minus of x is equal to 0.6. So I am subtracting. Now if you look at the equation 6.666 and 0.666, after the decimal the digits are same, so I can cancel it. It becomes 9x is equal to 6, x is equal to 6 upon 9, which is also equal to 2 upon 3. 0.47 bar. Now 0.47 bar means 7 is repeating. I will write it as x is equal to 0.47777. I will multiply both the sides by 10. It comes as 10x is equal to 4.777. Let it be equation number 1. Now if I use my x value and if I use my 10x value and if I see the places after the decimal, they are not same. So what I will do is I will multiply both the sides by 100 now. So it becomes 100x is equal to 47.7777. So after the decimal for equation 1 and equation 2, it is same. So I can subtract it easily. So subtract equation 1 from equation 2, we get 100x is equal to 47.777. Minus 10x is equal to 4.777. So after the decimal, the digits gets cancelled. So you get 90x is equal to 43 and x comes out to be 43 by 90. 0.001 bar, which means x is equal to 0.001001001. So here 3 digits are repeating every time. So I will multiply both the sides by 1000. So it becomes 1000x is equal to 1.00100001. So what will happen is after the decimal, I have the same digits now in equation 1 and equation 2. So I will subtract equation 1 from equation 2. I will get 1000x is equal to 1.00100001 minus x is equal to 0.00101. So after the decimal digits are same, I will cancel it. It becomes 999x is equal to 1. So x is equal to 1 upon 999. Express 0.9999 in the form of P upon Q. Are you surprised by your answer? With your teacher and classmates, discuss why the answer makes sense. Now let x be equal to 0.999. Let it be equation number 1. Let us multiply this with 10. So 10x is equal to 9.999. That is equation number 2. Let us subtract it. On subtracting, we get 9x is equal to 9 and x is equal to 1. Now we are expressing 0.99 and my answer of x comes as 1. So what happened is basically the difference between 1 and and the difference between 0.99, it is very small, very negligible, and that means it is very close to 1. So we can say that 1 answer is justified for this particular question. What can the maximum number of digits be in the repeating block of digits in the decimal expansion of 1 upon 17? Perform the division to check your answer. So let us divide 1 by 17. So here when you divide, it is a very long division. You need to go several times and you will realize that at the end you reach again 200, which was there your dividend we took it. And our answer, that's why it is repeating after 16 digits. So what is my number? 0.0588235294117647. So these are 16 digits. And after 16 digits, it will again repeat the same. Look at several examples of rational number in a form of P upon Q, and Q and P are the integers with no common factors other than 1 having terminating decimal representation. Can you guess what property Q must satisfy? Now here I have taken certain examples. Now say if I take 1 upon 4, it comes as 0.25. It is a terminating decimal. And if I look at the denominator, it is in a form of 2 raised to power 2. 4 can be written as 2 square. 7 upon 8 again is a terminating decimal. It is coming as 0.875, and if I look at the denominator, it is 2 cube. Next, 4 upon 5 can be written as 0.8. It is terminating, so it has a denominator 5 raised to power 1. 13 upon 20 is coming as 0.65, and it is again terminating, and it is in a form of 2 into 5. 2 square into 5 raised to power 1. So 2 and 5, it has the combination in the denominator. 1 upon 3. Now, if I do 1 upon 3, it comes as 0.333. It is a non-terminating decimal. So, denominator is in a form of 3 raised to power of 1. So, we see that with couple of examples, we notice that when we have denominator in a form of 2 or 5 or both, then the particular rational number is a terminating decimal. Write 3 numbers whose decimal expansions are non-terminating, non-recurring. So, we know certain numbers, root 2, root 3, root 5. You should know some values for this. So, it comes as 1.4142135. It goes on non-terminating it is and non-recurring. The numbers are not repeating. Root 3 is 1.73205080. Root 5 is 2.236067 and so on. So, certain values at least for 3 digit or 4 digit after the decimal, you should know the values of root 2, root 3 and root 5 for your future classes also. And there are certain other numbers like 0.01001000100001. These are what? These are non-terminating. They are not finishing and they are not repeating also. So, you can choose any such examples or any such numbers which can be taken as non-terminating and non-recurring. Find 3 different irrational numbers between the rational numbers 5 upon 7 and 9 upon 11. Now, first of all, we need to divide 5 upon 7 and 9 upon 11 to know what are their decimal expansions. If we see here, when we divide 5 by 7, we get 0.714285 bar because numbers will be repeating after that as we are again getting remainder as 5, which is the same as dividend. In the case of 9 by 11, it comes at 0.818181 because we are reaching to remainder as 9 every time. So, 81 is repeating. We need to find out any 3 numbers between these two. So, you can think of any three different irrational numbers so that we can write in between 5 upon 7 and 9 upon 11 taking the help of their quotient. So, I have written 3 of the numbers. You can choose any numbers, whatever you want, but it should be irrational. So, for irrational, I have written here as 0.72072007200. I have written as 0.74074007400 and 0.79079007900 like that. So, this becomes your irrational numbers. Classify the following numbers as rational or irrational according to their type. Now, let us check root 23. Now, we know root 23 is not a perfect square of any number. We know 25, 5 5s are 25, 4 4s are 16. So, 23 is not a perfect square. We need to find out its square root to check whether what type of rational or irrational number it is. On finding the square root of 23, we get 4.79583153331 and so on. It means that this number is non-terminating, first of all, and it is also non-recurring because numbers are not repeating. So, when it is non-terminating, non-recurring, we get it is an irrational number. Number 2, 225. We know 225, its square root is 15. So, it is definitely a rational number. 0.3796. So, it is already a terminating decimal. When it is a terminating decimal, it means it is a rational number. Next, 7.478478. Now, here 478 is repeating. Okay. But it is non-terminating. That means it is going on endlessly. So, it is non-terminating and repeating or recurring. So, it means it is a rational number. Next, 1.10100100100001 and so on. If you look at the expansion, you see that it is non-terminating first of all as it is going on and on. Number 2, it is non-repeating. Numbers are not repeating, they are changing. First there was 1 0, then there are 2 zeros, then there are 3 zeros, then there are 4 zeros, like so on. So, numbers is non-terminating and non-repeating. It means it is an irrational number. That's all for this exercise, children. I hope you must have found it very easy. Please do lots of practice. If you have doubt in any of the parts, you can mention in the comment section. You can also email me. Thank you so much, children, for watching the video till the end. Very soon, I am going to come with the next exercise. Till then, see you, children. Goodbye. Take care.